forget this at barbershop. Yeah,
you get one for free.
Don't forget this. Exactly.
Traveling the world with my wife hasn't slowed my love for doing guy stuff. And the one place that I always feel connected to my manhood is in a barber chair. Because I'm getting haircuts, beard trims, and neck shaves in unique places, I wanted to share the experiences with others that appreciate the craft of barbers around the world. Don't worry, I'll show you other cool cultural stuff along the way. These are my world barbershop adventures. Milwaukee, Wisconsin, about to get a haircut and a beard, my beard tightened up at the barber for the sports celebrities in Milwaukee, G's Clippers. Really excited about it, heard it so much about it from all my friends. I went to high school in Milwaukee, so this is going to be a really cool thing for me to have an experience in a barber chair of someone that is known in this city and has such a great brand and a great reputation. So looking forward to this trip into G's Clippers. Absolutely love the design of this barbershop. An old bank converted into a sports themed shop focusing on the Milwaukee Bucks basketball, it was like nothing I had ever experienced. Hardwood floors and basketball goals, a huge break room for the barbers, and an arcade room. Are you kidding me? The Milwaukee Tools workstations are very sharp, tons of memorabilia hang on the walls, and the flat screens throughout make it easy to keep up with the latest sports updates. The open layout and seating gives plenty of space for the long waiting periods that occur from Thursday to Saturday in the shop, and even though it's not as intimate as other barber shops I've experienced, you can still engage in entertaining conversations and storytelling in the chair, as you will see the two of us enjoy throughout my visit.
I probably need to be on Twitter. I haven't made a Twitter post in probably 2 years.
Yeah.
What about you?
I mostly read. I'll put posts on there, like some sports stuff. If my buddies are talking about like boxing or the games or stuff, I'll every once in a while I'll comment. If there's something I like, I'll retweet it.
Okay.
But for the most part, yeah, it's the way that I like to use Twitter is mostly just to consume what's going on.
But Instagram, for me, I don't have anything to be more user friendly. And Instagram.
You can just, minutes Instagram. Just go by on this thing.
Yeah.
I jump on there sometimes like, oh, you gotta get away from this.
Right.
20 minutes will go by so fast.
Exactly.
It is amazing how good that
is. Yeah, I like it. I like Instagram.
It's awesome. Yeah, and then I'll target barbers or beauty politicians, or sometimes I'll target travelers, and that's the way that just to get more eyes on it, and then they'll end up following that route. Why was Scottie Pippen at that game last night?
You know what? I wouldn't be surprised to see anybody at a conference finals game.
Oh, really?
Or a final game?
Yeah.
He bounced anybody, man.
Okay.
Really?
I didn't know if he had an invested interest. Yeah. Curry. And you see everything he does. Like, in a season, he has more highlights than some of the dudes in the 80s had in their career. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's amazing.
His shooting ability is uncanny. Like, it's unbelievable.
Oh, here's a funny story. While I was traveling, so I was in Tokyo.
Uh-huh.
And I went and got a workout in, and I had about a 20-minute walk home. And I was just walking through Tokyo, and when I walk the streets, I walk pretty fast anyway. And to my right, a 6'5 black guy walks by me with a hat on, and he was dressed very like metro-ish.
Stop. Okay.
And we made eye contact. I said, "What's up?" He kept walking by me, and then I was like about 6 steps after he was ahead of me, I was like, "Damn, that was Russ Westbrook."
Serious, man?
Yeah, in my head, I'm like, "That was Russ Westbrook." So I walked back to the place where we're staying, my wife and I, and I jumped on Twitter. I was like trying to figure out if he was in town. Sure enough, he had been in China like 4 days before that.
Are you serious?
Yeah, so I have a buddy, when I coached at Tyler, the head coach there was that he just went to Arkansas, he was at Oklahoma. So I hit him real quick, and his name's Chris Crutchfield, and I said, "Crutch, man, are you friends with anybody in the Westbrook camp?" I said, "I'm over here in Tokyo, I swear I just saw him." And he said, I'm friends with his brother, let me get back to you." The next day, he hits me back, he's like, "Dude, he was there."
Wow.
Yeah, so I'm like, man, I could have said something to Westbrook, but yeah, he walked right by me in Tokyo. Crazy.
30 million people.
Yeah, in another part of the world, yeah. But I knew it was him.
Whose birth name is Gollian Smith, is an outstanding barber who is humble enough to ask the right questions. Here he is making sure he gets my beard aligned to my liking. G is not only a great barber, but a detailed, focused businessman, important figure in the community, and extremely focused on his health, whether it's on the bike or running marathons. With the long list of local athletes and important businessmen that visit the shop, he takes advantage of his community presence by hosting events that focus on empowering men by educating them with speakers every month or two. Not only is he deeply invested in himself and the barbershop, but he is giving back so much to the city of Milwaukee.
Fridays and Saturdays sometimes really gets challenging.
And plus, to which you start having a little bit of success with the thing that you're super wealthy.
Right, exactly. Like, oh, well, don't forget this is a barbershop.
Yeah, can I get one for free?
Don't forget this. Exactly. That's funny. Yeah. This is still a barbershop now. It's not a Fortune 500 company.
Houston, because I can remember sitting in his kitchen when he was like 15, you know what I mean? Right. Just learning to cut hair.
Right.
And now he's got his own shop. And now he's like... Today, these kids now, these Milwaukee kids are unbelievable.
Yeah, we got some talent now.
Unbelievable.
Yes, that's Jalen Johnson.
Yes.
And then Patrick Baldwin.
Yes.
And then you got this kid that just moved up from Texas that's going to be on Washington. That Trey, what's his name? The sophomore, Trey, the sophomore that plays at Washington, that kid.
Yeah, that kid, the one that came from Texas.
Well, no, there's a, there's one that's been here, and then there's a one that just came from Texas.
Yeah.
So which one? Oh, Foster.
Foster, yes, yes. Yeah.
Used the shaving cream that G used in the chair, Cremo Shaving Cream, for over 5 years now. And with the expansion of their product line, they now offer many grooming products like aftershave balms, beard oils, and even body wash. I get my cream on Amazon, but it's available in many retail stores. I really appreciate G's attention to detail around the ears and neckline. His focused craftsmanship demonstrates why he has been so successful for over 20 years.
I really enjoyed that visit in G's Clippers today. Such a great time in his chair, especially for somebody that has as much business that he has to take care of. Not only on the day-to-day with all those chairs he has in his in the shop, but his partnerships, everything he's doing in the community, to for him to still have the Clippers in his hands and do the type of job that he does. You can see the cut, the fade, the ball fade, everything that he does. Fantastic barber, but still juggling just a centerpiece in his community. Knows so many people, and to have that amazing, gorgeous shop, it was just a pleasure to be in his chair and to experience that with him, and it was a lot of fun.
how amazing is G's Clippers, right? Please comment down below. And if you like the video, give me a thumbs up and subscribe to see more videos of me and barbershops around the world.